क्लास, वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 5। सो इन लेक्चर नंबर 4 आई एंडेड विद द थ्री स्टेट मॉडल ऑफ अ पावर सिस्टम, वेयर आई सेड दैट देयर आर थ्री स्टेट्स इन अ पावर सिस्टम: नॉर्मल स्टेट, इमरजेंसी स्टेट एंड रिस्टोरेटिव स्टेट। सो वी आर सेइंग दैट इफ देयर इज सम डिस्टर्बेंस इन द सिस्टम और इफ सम कंटिजेंसी अराइजेज इन द सिस्टम विल एंटर फ्रॉम नॉर्मल स्टेट टू इमरजेंसी स्टेट। ओके, इन द नॉर्मल स्टेट बोथ इक्वालिटी and equality and inequality constants, they are satisfied. However, in emergency state, equality constants are satisfied, but inequality constants, they are not satisfied. So I will represent it by this dash. Okay, so you know this equality constants, they are the real and reactive power balance. Okay, means where we use equality sign. Okay, means where there is a balance in there is equal sign in equality sign in the equation of real power, and there is equality sign in the equation of reactive power. And this inequality constant, basically we don't have equality sign here, but we have a range, a minimum and maximum range in inequality constants. Okay, so we are saying if some restorative control of if some emergency control is not taken here, okay, if emergency control is not taken, there is possibility the system may enter from emergency state to the restorative state. Okay, and in restorative state, both equality and inequality constants, both are not satisfied. Okay, so a system can directly enter from normal state to the restorative state in case the contingency is severe. Okay, so once the system has entered from normal state to emergency state, it is the responsibility of the operator to bring the system back from the emergency state to the normal state, and this is done by using a control which is called as emergency control. Okay, and in order to bring the system back from restorative state to normal state, some restorative or preventive control is required. This is restorative control. Okay, and this is emergency control. Look, this system was given by D. Liakow in 1967. I think 1967. Was it 90? Yes, it was 1967. So basically, if you will see, the system will directly grow from normal to the emergency state. However, later it was thought that this three-state model, it is not sufficient. Okay, because directly we are going from normal state to emergency state. So it was thought that before this emergency state, a alert sign should go to the alert signal should go to the operator, so that the operator can see, okay, there is some problem in the system and we have to do something or we have to take some action in order to bring the system back to the normal state. So this three state model was discarded and a five state model was adopted. And a five state model was adopted, and this model was given by Carson. Okay, so also known as the Carson's model. Okay, in five state model, these three states were present and two more states were added. So the model will look like, firstly we have a normal state. Okay, normal. So then we say that the system will not move directly from normal to the emergency state. First, the system will go from normal to the alert state, where an alert signal is given to the operator. Okay, in the alert state, still both the constants are satisfied. Alert state. So here we are saying E and I are satisfied. Again here, E and I are satisfied. Okay, we are saying the system, if some contingency is taking place, the system is going from normal to alert state. Okay, so what is happening in the alert state? Still equality and inequality constants, they are satisfied, but here they are satisfied, but they are about to violate, means the constraints may violate after the alert state, means they are still in the alert state, the system is still in the alert state, the constraints are still satisfied, but they are about to violate. Okay, so definitely in the alert state, the operator will have some command, or some authority to make some adjustment in the power system so that the system will again move back from the alert to the normal state. Okay, this alert state is included so that we can avoid the system to go from normal state to the emergency state directly, because there are some contingencies which are not severe. Okay, if some contingencies they are not severe, means some change in slight change in load, still the system is entering the emergency state. So that's why we have added one more state, alert state. Some control action is taken here at this place so that the system is again going back to the normal state, though in both the states equality and inequality constraints they are both satisfied. But in the alert state, the constraints are about to violate. Okay, if this control action is not taken here, what will happen? The system may go to the emergency state. Okay, the system may go to the emergency state. And in emergency state, you know that equality is satisfied and inequality, it is not satisfied. Okay, so here we have included one more state. No, with the help of this alert state, we are not allowing the system to go from this normal state to directly into the emergency state. Okay, because I have one more control here, and which is called as alert control. Okay, so now we want the system to move back from the emergency to the alert state. Then we will have one control here, which is called as, I already told you in the three state model, which is called as emergency control. Let me light here, emergency control. Okay, so if there is a condition when emergency control, still there is some problem in the system, disturbance, if the disturbance is still in the system, what will happen? The system will move from emergency to extreme state. It is called as in extremist mean extreme states. So we are going from emergency to extreme state, and in extreme state we are saying both equality and inequality, they both are violated. In which state? In extremist state. Okay, this is called as the extreme condition. This is emergency, this is extreme. In extreme condition, all the constraints are violated. For example, suppose there is some fault in the system, or suppose we have 10 generators. Out of 10 generators, 4 generators have developed some fault, and we are taking the 4 generators out of the systems. So the remaining load is to be shared by the 6 generators. So, and if the 6 generators, they don't have the capacity to satisfy the rated load, what we have to do then? At that time, we have to go for the load shedding. We have to go for the load shedding and resynchronization of the remaining healthy system. So what we do here in extremist state, what is done? Load shedding is done. Load shedding is done. And resynchronization. Is done. For the remaining healthy units. For the remaining system. So, if load shedding is done and resynchronization is done for the remaining system, what will happen? Then we will move from extreme state to the restorative state. Okay, so when this, how will we go from extreme state to restorative state? By load shedding and resynchronization. So I will write here resynchronization. Okay, so in order to bring the system back to the normal state from the restorative state, we need some restorative or preventive control. Restorative control. Okay, so I am saying, if there is some extreme or some contingency in the emergency state, then the system will move from the emergency state to the extreme state. However, if we are in the alert state and some severe contingency arises, very severe contingency arises, then the system can move directly from the alert to the extreme state. Okay, depending upon the magnitude of the contingency, ओके और द सिवेरिटी ऑफ द कंटीजेंसी द सिस्टम कैन मूव फ्रॉम अलर्ट टू द इमरजेंसी और फ्रॉम अलर्ट टू द एक्सट्रीम स्टेट. इफ द कंटीजेंसी इज नॉट सिवियर वी विल गो फ्रॉम अलर्ट, सिस्टम विल गो फ्रॉम अलर्ट टू इमरजेंसी स्टेट. बट इफ द कंटीजेंसी इज सिवियर देन द सिस्टम विल मूव फ्रॉम डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम अलर्ट टू द एक्सट्रीम स्टेट. ओके नो देयर आर आइदर वी कैन गो फ्रॉम रिस्टोरेटिव स्टेट टू द नॉर्मल स्टेट और वी कैन गो फ्रॉम रिस्टोरेटिव टू द अलर्ट स्टेट. ओके इन बोथ द केसेस रिस्टोरेटिव कंट्रोल इज रिक्वायर्ड. रिस्टोरेटिव कंट्रोल इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो लुक व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द थ्री स्टेट मॉडल एंड अ फाइव स्टेट मॉडल. इन अ थ्री स्टेट मॉडल फ्रॉम डायरेक्टली वी आर गोइंग फ्रॉम नॉर्मल स्टेट टू इमरजेंसी स्टेट. ओके सो मीन्स हियर द ऑपरेटर मीन्स वी डोंट हैव एनी वार्निंग फ्रॉम द सिस्टम पावर सिस्टम. वी डोंट द ऑपरेटर विल नॉट गेट एनी वार्निंग दैट ओके सम द कॉन्स्टेंट इनइक्वालिटी कॉन्स्टेंट इज अबाउट टू वायलेट सो डू सम मतलब ना टेक सम करेक्टिव एक्शन हियर. हाउएवर इन केस ऑफ दिस फाइव स्टेट मॉडल हियर वी हैव दैट ना फ्लेक्सीबिलिटी. ओके हियर द ऑपरेटर नोज ओके द इनइक्वालिटी कॉन्स्टेंट इज अबाउट टू वायलेट. So let us take some suitable action so that this inequality constant it will not violate and the system will move back to the normal state. So there it will provide this system is more helpful or this five state model it is means I will say it is more adaptive as compared to this three state model. Okay. And another we have from emergency we are not directly going to the emergency state, we are not directly going to the restorative state. We are from emergency we are going to the extreme state. Extreme state means the power system is in the extreme condition. Extreme condition means that many constraints are violated. Means equality, inequality, these constraints are violated. And then we have to resynchronize the system. And after resynchronization the system will come back from the extreme to the restorative state. So because of these two, because of this alert feature, this five state model was adopted. Okay. So this was all about the five state model of a power system. Next, I will tell you something about what is security constraint optimal power flow. Security constraint optimal power flow. These are small concepts, but these concepts are very much helpful. Okay. So this was lecture 5, page number 2. I'm talking about the security constraint optimal power flow. Optimal power flow. What do you mean by security constraint? What is optimal power flow? Optimal power flow means that the power means that we are that the power that the power system is operating in an optimum manner. Optimum manner means where the means minimum cost. Okay, we are minimizing the cost. Okay, and we are satisfying all the constraints. Okay, optimal power flow means we are minimizing the cost and we are satisfying all the constraints. Means all the constraints. Equality and inequality constraints, they are not violated, they are satisfied, and also the cost is minimum. So we studied basically this is economic load dispatch, means we are supplying the power in economic load dispatch. What we are trying to do, we are trying to minimize the cost of generation. Okay, so we are trying to minimize the cost of generation. Once we minimize the cost of generation, so it has certain advantages. Number one advantage is it will give more profit to the company which is supplying power. The number second advantage is that the company can supply power to the consumers at a cheaper rate. Okay, because generation is cheaper, so the obviously the cost of generation is cheaper, obviously the supply the power that is supplied to the consumer it will be supplied at cheaper rates. Okay, so these are certain advantages of economic load dispatch. So after this lecture, after this unit, I will start with economic load dispatch. But first, let me tell you something about security constraint optimal power flow. So suppose I am saying that I have a system. I am taking a case of a two machine system. I have one generator here. This generator is connected to a bus. And I have another bus here. This bus is also connected to a generator here. And I have load at this bus. Okay. So I am saying this is my unit 1. This is my unit 2. And these units आर कनेक्टेड बाय अ डबल सर्किट लाइन. ओके दीज यूनिट्स आर कनेक्टेड बाय अ डबल सर्किट लाइन, दीज आर द टू ट्रांसमिशन लाइन्स. ओके सो आई एम सेइंग माई लोड डिमांड इज 1200 मेगावाट. ओके द पावर दैट इज जनरेटेड बाई दिस जनरेटर, दिस जनरेटर इज सप्लाइंग 700 मेगावाट एंड दिस जनरेटर इज सप्लाइंग 500 मेगावाट. सो 700 प्लस 500 टोटल 1200. सो दिस 1200 मेगावाट लोड इज सेटिस्फाइड बाई दीज टू जनरेटर्स. आई एम निगलेक्टिंग द लॉसेज हियर, आई एम नॉट अज्यूमिंग द लॉसेज, आई एम सेइंग दैट देयर इज नो लॉस इन द सिस्टम. सो दिस होल 5 प्लस 7, 500 प्लस 700, 1200 मेगावाट इज सप्लाई टू दिस 1200 मेगावाट लोड. ओके सो दिस लाइन्स दे हैव सम सर्किट ब्रेकर्स एट बोथ द एंड्स. ओके ओके आई एम सेइंग दैट दिस इज द ऑप्टिमम डिस्पैच, मीन्स ऑप्टिमम मीन्स चीपेस्ट, मीन्स 700 फ्रॉम दिस यूनिट एंड 500 फ्रॉम दिस यूनिट. इफ आई एम जनरेटिंग 500 फ्रॉम दिस यूनिट एंड 700 फ्रॉम दिस यूनिट एंड आई एम सप्लाइंग दिस पावर टू दिस 1200 मेगावाट लोड, आई एम सेइंग द कॉस्ट ऑफ जनरेशन इज मिनिमम, इट इज ऑप्टिमल. ओके एट द सेम टाइम आई एम सेइंग दैट आई हैव अ डबल सर्किट लाइन हियर, आई एम सेइंग द कैपेसिटी ऑफ ईच लाइन इज 400 मेगावाट. आई एम सेइंग दैट पी एल मैक्स ऑफ ईच लाइन, पी एल मैक्स मीन्स लाइन्स इज हो मच 400 मेगावाट. ओके सो ईच लाइन हैज़ अ मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी टू सप्लाई टू कैरी 400 मेगावाट ऑफ पावर. सो हाउ दिस पावर विल बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड, सो 500 मेगावाट इज टू बी ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम दिस बस टू दिस बस. ऑब्वियसली 250 मेगावाट विल गो फ्रॉम दिस बस, दिस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन एंड 250 मेगावाट विल फ्लो फ्रॉम दिस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन. गॉट इट? आई एम सेइंग दिस इज माई ऑप्टिमल पावर डिस्पैच. ऑप्टिमल मीन्स चीप एंड ओके ऑप्टिमल बट नॉट सिक्योर, आई एम सेइंग इट इज ऑप्टिमल. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज पोस्ट कंटीजेंसी कंडीशन. पोस्ट कंटीजेंसी डिस्पैच एंड दिस पोस्ट कंटीजेंसी डिस्पैच अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस 500 मेगावाट एंड 700 मेगावाट, आई एम सेइंग इट इज ऑप्टिमल फ्लो, ऑप्टिमल फ्लो और ऑप्टिमल डिस्पैच. ओके गॉट इट? सो वॉट इज पोस्ट कंटीजेंसी डिस्पैच? ऑप्टिमल पोस्ट कंटीजेंसी डिस्पैच, ऑप्टिमल मीन्स 500 फ्रॉम दिस एंड 700 फ्रॉम दिस, सो कॉस्ट ऑफ जनरेशन इज मिनिमम. ओके सो आई एम सेइंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ ईच लाइन इज 400 मेगावाट, मीन्स दिस लाइन कैन कैरी 400 मेगावाट ऑफ पावर एंड दिस लाइन कैन ऑल्सो कैरी 400 मेगावाट ऑफ पावर. सो मैक्सिमम, बट दीज आर टू पैरेलल लाइन्स, सो पावर विल बी इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड बट डिवाइडेड बिटवीन दीज टू लाइन्स. सो 250 विल बी कैरीड बाई दिस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन एंड 250 विल बी कैरीड बाई दिस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन एंड देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम. मैक्सिमम इट कैन कैरी 400 एंड राइट नो इट इज कैरिंग 250 एज पर द ऑप्टिमल डिस्पैच. ओके एंड दिस डिस्पैच इज कॉल्ड ऑप्टिमल. सो टेल मी, सपोज देयर इज अ फॉल्ट समवेयर हियर ऑन दिस लाइन. Okay, so if there is fault on this line, what will happen? This is post contingency dispatch. Contingency means fault. Fault is also a contingency. Okay, fault is also a contingency, means post contingency. This is not, sorry, post, this is pre contingency. Pre contingency means before. Post means after. So this is pre contingency dispatch, which is called, which is the optimal dispatch. Now I am saying some fault is developed here at this point. I am saying a fault is developed at this point. What will happen? So these circuit breakers will come into picture and what will happen? These circuit breaker will open and they will remove this line from the circuit. Okay. How the circuit will look like? I'm saying the circuit will look like this. This line is like this. And here it will go like this, circuit breaker is open and this circuit breaker is also open. Got it? This is my unit 1. This was supplying 500 megawatt and this was my unit 2, this was supplying 700 megawatt and this was 1200 megawatt load. Are you getting it? Now tell me, now this line is tripped. So from which line this 500 megawatt power will flow? This 500 megawatt power will flow from this line. Are you getting? So I am saying a fault is developed on this line, and because of this fault, these circuit breakers will operate and they will remove this line from the circuit. Now this line is open from both the ends, so all the 500 megawatt power will flow from this line. Okay, so what is the maximum capacity of this line to carry power? The maximum capacity of this line to carry power is 400 megawatt. Both can carry only 400 megawatt of power, but now this line, it is open, so whole power will flow through this line. Now 500 megawatt power is flowing through this line, but this line has a capacity to carry only 400 megawatt of power. So what is this 500? It is overload. It is overloaded. This line is overloaded, and this condition is, means this is after fault condition now I am talking about. So this is called as post fault or post contingency. Post contingency dispatch. So tell me, is this dispatch, post contingency dispatch, secure or not secure? This, because this line is overloaded, it has a maximum capacity to carry 400 megawatt, but now it is carrying 500 megawatt, so this line is overloaded. So because of the overload, this line will also trip. So that is why we are saying this condition, this post contingency dispatch, according to this 500 megawatt at this, from this unit, and 700 megawatt from this unit, this is not secure. Not secure at all, because it leads to overloading of this line. Okay. So what we have to do? So for that we have certain programs. Okay, what we can do, we can lower the generation at this unit and we can raise the generation at this unit. Okay, lowering the generation, if I will lower the generation at this unit by 100 megawatt, and if I will raise the generation at this unit by 100 megawatt, what will happen? 400 megawatt, the picture will look like this. Unit 1. Unit 2, load is 1200 megawatt. Now I am saying instead of 700, it is generating 800 megawatt, and instead of 500, it is generated 400 megawatt. So what will happen? 200 megawatt will flow from this line, and 200 will flow from this line. Okay, so what is 4 plus 8? This is 12. 4 plus 8, 12, and 1200 megawatt is my load. Okay, so this type of dispatch, this is called secure dispatch. This is called secure dispatch. Now look, now in this condition, if I am saying there is a fault at this point, so we have circuit breakers here on both the ends of all the lines. So I am saying if some fault is developed at this point, how the picture will look like? The picture will look like this. Here I have 800 megawatt, and here I have, this is unit 1, 400 megawatt, and I have a load here, how much? 1200 megawatt. Okay, so now if there is fault on this line and these circuit breakers open, so this line is out of the circuit, because it is open circuit from both the sides. So this whole 400 megawatt power will flow from this line. And what is the maximum capacity of this line? 400 megawatt. Okay, so here you can see that this line is not overloaded, because it is operating at its maximum value. It is not going beyond 400 megawatt. If it will go beyond 400 megawatt, we will say the line is overloaded, but it is 400 megawatt. So I will say this is secure post contingency, secure post contingency dispatch. So this was post contingency dispatch, but this was not secure. This is post contingency dispatch, but secure post contingency dispatch. In this case, if there is fault in one line, the other line will not get overloaded. However, in case if there was fault on one line, the other line was getting overloaded. Though this was optimal, but it was not secure. This is optimal, but not optimal as much as this case. This is also optimal, but not optimal as this one. But this is secure. So this process, what we are doing basically, this was the when there was no na, there was not any fault in the system. Okay, so at that time, like this, there is no fault in the system. At that time, we are reducing the power from this generator and we are increasing the output of this generator by the same amount. Okay, so this means in the we are saying in the in the pre-contingency dispatch, we are making adjustments in generations. Okay, so that in the pre-contingency state, we are making adjustment in generations. So these are the adjustments in generation. Okay, so that in the post-contingency, the constraints are not violated. This is called as QRT constraint, optimum power flow. So let me take the another page. So what does it mean? It means programs which can make control adjustments. Which can make control adjustment to the base or pre-contingency operation to prevent violations in the post-contingency conditions are called security constraint, optimum power flow. So I am saying programs which can make control adjustment in the base or pre-contingency operations to prevent violations in the post-contingency conditions are called security constant optimum power flow. Security constant optimum power flow, in short, it is SCOPF scope. Okay, what I am saying, this is lecture number 2 notes. I am saying programs which can make adjustment in the base means healthy, when the system was healthy, in the base or pre-contingency operation to prevent violations in the post-contingency operation. Okay, if you will see here, it is pre-contingency, okay, or post or base condition. At that time, no adjustment was made, so in the post-contingency constraints were violated. However, if we are making adjustment in the base conditions, here this is the case where adjustment is made. Now we are saying in the post contingency condition, constraints are not violated. So this thing is called as the programs which perform such functions, okay, which make such control adjustments, okay, into the base condition. So these programs are called as security constraint optimum power flow. Security constraint means it is secure, and constraint means constraints are not violating. So that is why it is called security constraint optimum power flow. So the last topic of lecture number 1 now. So in the last topic, I will tell you something about this now. Basic structure of power system operation and control, where all the functions will be shown in one single diagram. Okay, so I think I will fall short of space on this page, and I will use another page here, right here, page number 4, lecture 5. So I will draw the diagram. So while watching the video, you please try to draw this diagram. while watching this video, because once I will finish with this diagram, it will be difficult for you guys to understand. Okay, so first important equipment, basically first important component of any this na power system operation and control problem, we can only control a system if we can monitor, if we can measure. Okay, so for that we need some devices which can acquire data from the field, and this data they can transfer to the control center. Okay, so for that we need the equipment which performs these functions. That equipment is called as RTU. RTU. So one RTU cannot fetch all the data from the field. So we need number of RTUs which are installed at some different locations. Okay, so what these RTUs do, they can transfer the data and they can receive the signal as well. Means they can transfer the data and they can receive the control signal from the control center. So this is that is why the arrow is bidirectional. So but they can transfer or receive this data information, they can transfer or receive information through telemetry. Okay, this is telemetry. Telemetry. So what what type of information does we receive from this RTUs? It will supply us all the information from the power system, like what is the voltage, what is the angle, what is frequency, what is current, what is the status of our circuit breakers, and what is the status of our isolator switches. Okay, so first I will take first type of data which is called as circuit breaker.